Talk about French things.
Yeah.
This is the Frenchest of all seas. You couldn't get any more stereotypically French.
There we go.
There's that a stereotypically French scene. A couple of two CVs going past. Fantastic. So we've had our dinner and a bit of a chit chat, and now we're just arriving at the hotel. But look at the ancient obelisk church behind. Insane, it's beautiful. Who would have known it here in Lille? California raised us right, kicking our feet routine, but what are we all trying to find out? Two worlds collide, paralyzed, just in time. Oh, two worlds collide, paralyzed, just in time. Oh,
get it?
Wow.
Parnassus.
The place is called the Imaginarium. That's a Batman swagger. Gigantic Game Boy.
Loving like a machine. What have you sacrificed? Lost in the crowd, fighting to
become a stranger. And at the end, you're going to do a little
show read
of the visit?
Yeah, we just cut it up, put it on LinkedIn.
Oh, wonderful.
Steve?
Just in case I forget who I am, here at the Imaginarium, which is a co-working innovation space. See what they're all about in here.
Hi everybody, I'm Mel Damar, I'm director for Fred Image. I'm really glad to welcome you here this morning. You will have a full presentation by your time just after one. Discover the environment or the companies that are settled here, the way they can, you can collaborate with them, because I think together we are stronger, and together as Europeans against versus Americans, Asians and so on, I think we need to merge, to work together, to be stronger together.
No.
Well, this is like being in Star Wars.
Have you ever been in Star Wars?
Yes, loads of times. Episode 1 to 9.
Hold the hologram. I'll let you talk.
Yes. Okay, so we manufacture holograms like this one. Really small device, so it's like movies to distribute. We use them to make art like this behind you, film with any camera, and you have an hologram.
Wow.
You can put directly into the screen.
The film doesn't do it any justice, but it looks wicked.
Loving like a machine. What have you sacrificed?
open reality experience tour.
I was about to start capturing some video myself, then I realised we had that on board.
Yeah, this is it.
So I'll just look on your channel.
Just follow me.
Later.
Just follow me.
Thanks.
So we're going, what is it, a virtual experience room? Virtual experience room.
Yeah.
Is that a virtual experience room?
Open reality experience.
Open reality experience. Which I think is real life. But they're convincing me it's not.
We're about to experience
real
the
life.
Experience.
We're about to experience experiences. That could be quite fun, actually. I like experiencing experiences.
Well, yeah. It's getting darker, that's all I
need
to tell
you. It's getting darker. It's getting...
Glasses while they
clear.
What's
going on? How'd you feel, Dan, from Wonderful?
Stepping maybe not too much like further because the warning you that
you can't really. Oh, that's cool. So this is the open reality room. Open reality. You put these glasses on, step into a massive screen, and it's like VR, but without
a big headset.
VR without the big headset.
You just see this a bit clearer.
Pretty much.
It's not that great. It's just making me feel
quite
ill.
Disorientated.
It's very disorientated. It's making me feel ill.
I need to get back onto the ground.
Yeah, you get seasick. But it's quite cool. I'm gonna give up though and get out. Have a go.
Thank you.
Makes you feel a bit ill.
Yeah, I think so.
Makes you feel a bit sick.
Well, that's probably the beer as well.
It might be the beer. It is a bit like a holodeck out of Star Trek. That is the coolest thing about it.
Yeah, but it's a lot more disorienting than I'm sort of happy with.
You've got your shoes. You've got to take your shoes off to enter the holodeck, and some childish person hid Dan's shoes, but he's got them back now. He's got them. He's got his shoes back. That's the second time a grown man on this trip has lost his shoes. Behind the VR room, and it's a bulb that comes out with projectors, about 12 projectors all around it. It's really, really quite impressive. See, you say you start your ones with hello friends. I tend to always start with so here we are. Deck chairs in a co-working space, an innovation centre, which is pretty cool. A nice relaxed vibe. The parasols are a bit unnecessary. I'm sure they do serve a purpose on a day. Nice and relaxing. In the crowd, fighting to feel fine. Something that they've designed and is very famous in France. I don't know what it is, but apparently it's really famous.
Thus ends our journey.
Thus.